A man believed to be the BSU stalker that raised alarms across campus last fall is behind bars. 27-year-old Andy Gallegos was sentenced to 30 years in prison on separate rape charges from 2010. Gallegos admitted to the crimes, as well as breaking into girls' rooms to steal underwear and inappropriately touch them. Gallegos was arrested in January, but it wasn't until today that police released information that he is believed to be the campus stalker. No new reports of a stalker have surfaced since his arrest. Joining us to talk about this is Boise's Chief of Police, Bill Bones. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So let's talk about this. It's pretty clear that there's DNA evidence linking Gallegos to those rapes in 2010, correct?
That's correct. The DNA absolutely confirmed that.
And
he was the suspect.
He also did admit to that. And what about evidence for those stalking cases?
Well, for the stalking cases, the ability when we got the DNA evidence gave us a search warrant, which officers and detectives were able to serve on his residence. They actually found physical evidence, including women's underwear, which tied him to the prowling calls that we'd had.
I think a lot of people breathing a sigh of relief after hearing that.
Yeah, you know, we've got many students that are coming back to school. We've got many people that live in those communities and neighborhoods, and they can know that they are safe in those homes, that he is where he belongs in jail, because he is a violent criminal predator.
So, Chief, tell me how this works, because up until this point, we really hadn't heard of that connection with this individual in the stalking cases. Why wasn't that brought up during this particular trial leading up to his conviction? And will he be charged on those extra crimes down the road?
Some of those are questions for the prosecutor's office, but in any case that involves sexual abuse, it sometimes victimizes the person who was victimized twice in a trial. And so a prosecutor really looks at that. In this case, they were actually able to get a plea bargain on the two rape cases that they had, getting a 30-year sentence on that attempted rape charge, and didn't have to put the victims back through the stand, a long trial. And I believe that was probably part of the decision-making process, which occurred.
The judge was pretty outspoken in this case, obviously, and pretty upset, I think, with the situation, and wanted even more than the sentence he was able to give. Were you surprised by that?
I was very impressed with Judge Hippler and his comments. He certainly recognized the danger that Mr. Gallegos posed to our community. I think if he could have given him life, he would have given him life. But certainly 30 years with 20 years fixed was a significant sentence. We know he's going to prison. If he ever comes back out, he's going to be on our radar.
Chief, thanks for coming in tonight and letting us know more about this case. We appreciate it. Good work out there.
Thanks for having me.